Hello, everyone. Hold on. The Wi-Fi's been a little wonky, so hopefully it works. If not, let me know. But today, today I am going to actually start with philosophy because my day is a little hectic afterwards. Not hectic, but busy, and we're probably traveling. So I decided to start with some philosophy just a little bit, and then we'll transition into the asana. So feel free to grab your book or grab your notebook if you are following along. If you're just jumping in and you don't even know anything about what I'm talking about, then feel free to check out the book, The Fall of the Human Intellect, and go to vedantaworld.org if you want to see more things about my teacher, Swami Parthasarathy. And you can also watch the videos on Rena Yoga TV and my channel on YouTube. And we've led up to this point. So we are on, well, it was my page 24, but it's chapter 3 and the area of dilemma of choice. Hold on, I got some weird alert. Hold on a second. Fail to connect to server. All right, so start streaming. Apparently the Wi-Fi is not doing so great, so I apologize. I guess try to send me some notes and alerts if it's not working on your end. I'll do my best. There's only so much I can do about the Wi-Fi. Considering everybody's on it right now, it's probably like overloaded. And sorry for the sniffles, I'm not sick. It's just cold. So the dilemma of choice. Human actions emanate from either the mind or the intellect, or a combination of both. The body executes action, so the body can only act. But the body cannot act on its own, right? So it doesn't just like, the body's, my finger isn't like, I really want to go over here. No, it doesn't act on its own. It's only acting from a place of the mind or the intellect. So the actions of the body are driven by either the likes and dislikes, feelings, emotions, impulses of the mind, or reason, discretion, judgment of the intellect, or a combination of both. So you're either acting from a place of, oh, I really like this, I really want this, I really don't want this, I don't like this, right? Your feelings, this feels right, this is an emotion, oh, this is great, just jumping into it, right? Impulsive emotions, or from a place of discernment and reason. Right? So you're either just going for it, pausing, thinking about it, then making a decision based on that, or a combination of the above two. So you can make a decision, both the mind and intellect can be in conjunction, right? So that's obviously ideal because it's not as challenging, but ultimately the intellect is what needs to take control. So here's an example of the above three possibilities arising from an action. Offer a sweet to a diabetic person who is fond of sweets. His mind wants to take it. His intellect decides against it, knowing that he is a diabetic. If his intellect is more powerful than his mind, he will refuse it. If otherwise his mind is strong and intellect weak, he would accept it. In a third possibility, if the person is not diabetic, his mind and intellect may concur and consume it. People the world over operate more on feeling and emotion rather than reason and judgment. Ain't that the truth? Sometimes even the reasoning of the intellect is overpowered by the mind's emotions. Jane Taylor, in her poem, The Pond, portrays the idea beautifully. The poem describes a party of ducks preparing to a pond for its food and pastime. A young chicken that lived thereabout kept watching the ducks go in and out of the water, thoroughly enjoying themselves. She had a great desire to get into the pond and join in their fun and frolic. But her mother had warned her not to go into the water. One day, the chicken tried to reason to herself why should she not venture into the pond, despite her mother's warning. And arrived at a strange conclusion that the only difference between them and herself was the shape of their beaks. That her beak was pointed and their beaks were round. She found it to be no reason for her to drown. Thus submitting to her mind's obsession for swimming, her intellect thought she could swim as well as the ducks. So she plunged into the water only to find her mother's cautions were true. She sank to the bottom and died. So this is obviously an extreme version, but ultimately that's what our intellects is supposed to do for us, is protect us from that fatality of our minds, attachments and obsessions and emotions and fears and all that stuff that we're probably feeling right now, right? And not taking a moment to pause and have the intellect take over. There was an Instagram, a Facebook post that somebody asked, like, put your emotion, what's your quarantine drag queen name? And it was like, you're the last, your emotion plus the last thing you ate. And like 99.9 of them was like fear, anxiety, sad, worried. Like all of the emotions were pretty much negative. Like, and you know, in that space where I know, obviously I've had that as well. I've had all of that. And then there's an overwhelming feeling of gratitude also that could be feel that we would be feeling over us, right? If the intellect were to come in and be like, okay, but look at everything that you do have. You've lived an amazing life and you will continue to live an amazing life. You know, like just being in that space of shifting your perspective is huge right now. And so first understanding how much the mind can take hold of you, that's when you can go, okay, hold on a second. I'm going to pause and I'm going to allow myself to think this through and discern and be and have reason. And it is, you know, if you can reason and you're using the teachings, you're really, really helping yourself think rationally and reasonably instead of joining in with the other mentality, which is not going to be helpful. So, I'm gonna not read the poem today because I want you guys, I guess, I'm gonna just give you little tidbits. And so think about that in terms of how you can notice the difference of your actions and what your body is doing based on either an emotion or a reason. And get the book if you can. This is gonna be a lifesaver in this time, in any time of your life. And The Fall of the Human Intellect, A Partha Sarathi. I will put the spelling of the name because it's a little crazy. But yeah, so think about that. And then next time I join in, we will read the poem and discuss it and continue with chapter 3. But without further ado, we are going to do our asana practice. So, put this aside. I figured that today we could do a little bit more chill and but we'll still obviously work, but just kind of get deeper into the stretches and allow our bodies to kind of hold poses a little bit more and see where we go from there. How's that sound? Good. Good, I hope. It is what it is. We're in it together. So let's begin sitting comfortably cross-legged. Bring your spine long, squeeze the shoulder blades together. Place your hands onto your knees. You can make your thumb and index fingers touch, palms facing up or palms facing down. And close your eyes here and begin to breathe in and out through the nose deeply. As you inhale, expanding the belly out like a balloon. And as you exhale, draw the belly in towards the spine. Inhale, belly out like a balloon. Exhale, draw the belly in. And take a few deep breaths here just to let yourself settle. And bring your attention onto your mat, into your skin, into this clothes that you're wearing today. Gratitude for the clothes that you have, the mat beneath you, the carpet or the wood beneath you, the roof over your head. Really noticing all the small details. With no expectations of the future, just here now. Place your hands together in prayer position in front of your heart. Take a moment here to make your intention or dedication for class. And with this dedication in mind, we're going to start by chanting Om together once. Take a deep breath in. Head and fold forward over your legs. Keep your hips on the floor, shoulders back, relax the neck, relax the head. And take deep breaths in, deep breaths out. Close your eyes in this gentle forward bend. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Deep breath in, deep breath out. As you inhale, slowly walk your hands up. Switch your legs, whatever leg you had on top, bring it on the bottom or front or behind. Lengthen as you inhale and slowly walk your hands forward. Close your eyes, soften the face, soften the shoulders, soften the hips. And take three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. And one. Slowly inhale, walk your hands up. Bring your right hand behind your back, left hand on top of the right knee. Inhale, lengthen, and exhale, twist. Look over the right shoulder. Push the floor away from you and lengthen, finding gratitude for what you can see and that you can see. Not necessarily exactly what you're looking at, but the fact that you can see. Two more breaths. One more deep breath. And lift the right arm up by your ear. Keep holding onto that right knee with your left hand and lean all the way over to the left side. Peek under the right shoulder towards the ceiling and lean back, breathing through the nose. And if you want to put your own playlist at home today, you can go ahead and do that. Two deep breaths. And one, gently come up and twist to the left. Left hand behind the back, right hand on top of the left knee. Lengthen as you inhale. Twist as you exhale and breathe through the nose for three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. And one. Left arm comes up by the ear and lean over towards that right side as you use this right hand to peek under the left shoulder and open up the chest. Breathe through the nose for three. Two. And one, gently coming up. Good, hands on the knees. Inhale, shoulders up towards the ears, and exhale, drop them down. Inhale, shoulders up. Exhale, drop them down. Inhale, shoulders up. And exhale, drop them down. Roll the shoulders back and down for three, two, one. Roll the shoulders forward for three, two, and one. Tuck your chin into your chest and roll the head to the left and back as you inhale. I'll go to the left and back. Exhale, right and down. Realize that some of these videos look like I'm going one direction, but I'm going in the other direction. So just know that I'm going to the left and back. And then switch directions. Inhale, right and back. Exhale, left and down. Inhale, right and back. Exhale, left and down. One more circle. And tuck the chin into the chest. Interlace the fingers behind the head. Pull the elbows in and stretch the neck and the upper back. Pull the head forward, shoulders back, away from the ears. Elbows pull forward. And create some traction. Move your chin from side to side to create a nice stretch along the sides of the neck. And then push the head into the hand to lift up. Beautiful. Interlace the fingers behind your back. Press your knuckles into the floor. Arch back. Open up the chest. Breathe through the nose with three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. And release. Let's roll onto our hands and our knees. Let's come to all fours. So you're just going to spread the fingers, wrists under the shoulders, knees under the hips, and point the toes back. As you inhale, drop the belly and look up, shoulders back. Exhale, round your back and tuck your chin into your chest, belly in. Cat-cow movements, inhale, drop the belly, look up. Exhale, round your back and tuck your chin into your chest. Inhale, drop the belly, look up. And exhale, round your back and tuck your chin into your chest. Good. Come back to the center. Let's flare up the navel a little bit in the body. Tuck your toes under. Lift your knees an inch above the floor and same movement. Inhale, drop the belly, look up.
Exhale, round your back and tuck your chin in. It's just your knees are hovering. Inhale, drop the belly, look up. Feel a little bit of the burning. Exhale, round the back, tuck your chin in. Good, one more time. Inhale, drop the belly, look up. And exhale, round your back, tuck your chin in. And inhale, bring the knees down to the floor. Extend the right arm forward, left leg back. Flex that left foot, pull that left hip down, shoulder back and down. Draw the ribs in and hold for three deep breaths. Come on, extend in opposite directions. Two deep breaths. Keep feeling that body start to warm up. Feel that core active. One more deep breath. Extend. Bend that left leg. Reach back with your right hand. Kick the foot into the hand and open up the chest to the right. And breathe through the nose. Three deep breaths. Good. You can choose to flex the foot and press the heel up. Two deep breaths. Let me hear you at home. One more breath. And then extend. And then bring the hand and knee down. Other side. Right leg back, left arm forward. Lift, pull the ribs in. Push the floor away from you. Hold here. Breathe through the nose. We just talked about the dilemma of choice. If you opt to step out of something or to do something, are you doing it from emotion or from intellect? One more deep breath. Holding here. Bend that right leg, reach back with your left hand, and kick the foot into the hand as you open up the chest and look to the left. Reach and push that right hand into the floor. Three deep breaths. Hold. Two deep breaths. Squeeze. And one. Extend in opposite directions. And then exhale, lower the hand and the knee down. Point the toes, widen the knees, sit back on your heels, and come into your child's pose, Balasana. Forehead on the floor, arms by your side. Relax your head, relax your hips. Deep breath in through the nose. Deep breath out through the nose. And anytime you need to come into this child's pose, do so during your practice. Just make sure it's your intellect making the decision, not your mind. Good. Now reach the arms in front of you as far as you can. Spread the fingers wide. Inhale, come to all fours, tuck your toes under, lift your knees and your hips, downward facing dog, and begin to pedal your legs. Bend one knee at a time, bring the other heel towards the floor, side to side. Beautiful. Good. And then straightening out both your legs, shoulders pull back, lift the right leg up into the air, bend the right knee, open up the hip, pull that shoulder down, press the heel into the glute. And then gently step the right leg down, left leg up, bend the left knee, open up the hip, press the heel into the glute. Keep breathing Ujjayi and step the left leg down. Beautiful. From here, slowly walk your feet forward towards your hands. Keep your feet hip width apart. Grab your elbows, pull the elbows down, lift the toes up, lift the kneecaps up, spiral the thighs in and nod your head yes and no. Release tension from your neck and shoulders. Good. You can release the arms to the floor, tuck the chin into the chest, and slowly begin to roll up vertebra by vertebra, coming all the way up to standing. Beautiful. Toes and heels touching near the front of the mat. Lift your toes. Feel the four corners anchored down. Pew, 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 pew. Those four corners are pressed down into the floor. The arches are lifted. Toes lifted to activate the legs. Spiral the thighs in. Tuck the tailbone under. Fingertips point down. Crown of the head is reaching up. Close your eyes here for a moment and breathe deeply. Find that Ujjayi breath. Center yourself. Press down from the hips down. Waist lengthening up for two more deep breaths. You're pulling in polar opposites. Push the floor away from you and pull into the midline. Push the world away from you and anchor yourself within. One more breath. And inhale, circle those arms up and over the head, shoulders stay down. Exhale, swan dive forward with the flat back, hands next to the feet, drop the head. Inhale, look up, extend, lean forward, shoulders back. Exhale, step the right leg back into a lunge, hold. Let's bring the right knee down to the floor, point the right toes back, sink the hips, and lean back, coming into your crescent moon. So you can choose to stay here, sinking the hip with the hands overhead, or bring your hands to your waist.
Contract that right glute and push back with the left leg. Take two more breaths. One more deep breath. Good, and then circle the hands to the floor. Step the left leg back, plank position, top of the push-up as you slowly lower down to your belly. Point your toes, feet hip width apart, press the tops of the toes into the floor. Lift up the chest halfway for your cobra. Squeeze the shoulder blades together behind you, crown of the head reaching up. And then as you exhale, tuck your toes under, lift your hips downward facing dog. Beautiful. On the inhale, step the right foot all the way forward between the hands, sink the hips. You might need to take the hoodie off because it's going all over the place. Reach, point the left toes back, lift the chest, square the hips, reach the arms up over the head, breathe through the nose for three deep breaths, pressing that right foot into the floor. Two deep breaths, holding here. One more full breath. And then gently bringing the hands to the floor. Step the left foot to meet the right, feet together. Inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, forward bend over the legs. Keep the legs strong. Inhale, circle the arms out and up. Look up at the thumbs, tailbone under. And exhale, arms by your side. Again, inhale, circle up, shoulders down. Exhale, swan dive forward, hands towards the floor, drop the head. Inhale, look up, lean forward. Exhale, left leg back into a lunge. Sink the hips, point the left toes back. Reach the arms up over the head, shoulders back. Breathing in. Good, and exhale, both hands come down to the floor. Tuck the left toes under, step the right leg back. Lower to chaturanga. Point the toes, lift the chest, up dog. Exhale, tuck your toes under, lift your hips. Downward facing dog. Inhale, right foot forward between the hands. Point the left. Oh, it's the left foot. Just getting switch. Inhale, left foot forward between the hands. Right knee down. Arch up and back. Open up the chest. Press the right pinky toe down. Lengthen. Exhale, both hands come down. Step the right foot to meet the left. Inhale, look up, lengthen. Exhale, forward bend. And inhale, circle the arms out and up, look up at the thumbs, and exhale, samasthitihi. Good, one more, here we go, rise up, shoulders down. Exhale, uttanasana. Inhale, ardha uttanasana. Exhale, right leg back, point the right toes, lean way back, crescent moon. Exhale, both hands down. Inhale, left leg back. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Uddha Mukha Svanasana. Shoulders try to pull back. Despite shoulder injuries, exhale, Downward Facing Dog. Inhale, right foot forward, left knee down, arching back, open up the chest. Exhale, both hands come down, step the left foot to meet the right. Inhale, look up, lengthen. Exhale, forward bend. And inhale, circle the arms out and up, belly in. And exhale, arms by your side. Beautiful. Good. Separate your feet hip width apart. Sorry, I'm no itchy nose. Reach the arms up over the head. Grab your left wrist with your right hand and lean all the way over to the right side. Look under the left arm towards the ceiling and anchor both feet into the floor. Breathe through the nose for three deep breaths. Two deep breaths. And one, inhale up and switch. Grab your right wrist, lean all the way over to the right side. Look under the right arm. Belly in, lengthen. Three. Two. And one, inhale, gently lift. Lengthen. And then exhale, feet together. Forward bend all the way down. Inhale, look up, lean forward. Belly in. Exhale, you can choose to step or hop back. Slowly lowering down to the bottom of the push-up. Inhale, up dog or cobra, shoulders try to pull back. And exhale, downward facing dog. Now lift that right leg up into the air again, bend that right knee, open up the hip towards the side, press the heel in, keep the shoulders down. Good, and make circles with your hip in one direction. And make circles with your hip in the other direction. Opening it up. Good, and then step that right foot all the way
forward between the hands, left heel stays lifted, spiral the thighs in, reach your arms up over the head, coming into your lunging warrior. Spiral the thighs, pull the bowler, shoulders pull down, and extend the spine for three. Pull, push away, pull to the midline. Two more breaths. And one. As you exhale, open up into your warrior two, look over the right middle finger. I'm gonna just change sides so I can see you guys at home and you guys can see me. So bending that knee, extending in opposite directions, and opening that hip, breathing through the nose, lifting up the toes, those four corners pressing down. So when I say push the world away from you, stay in the pose. When I say push the world away from you, I don't mean push people away, right? Like we're doing that physical distancing, which we have to do anyway, but it's not like social distancing is the difference. We're still able to be intimate. We're still able to be centered. We're still able to connect. We don't cut people out. We're not affected by people. That's what pushing the world away means. It means that that's not what your highest essential is in the world, but beyond the world is what's most important. Good, one more deep breath. I know you're in it. Straighten out that right leg. Toe heel your left foot in without falling backwards. Open up and come into your triangle pose. Right hand down, left hand up, and look up at the left thumb. So engage these quads. Open up the chest. Pull in the navel. Shoulders draw back. Feel free to grab that toe or use a block. Take three deep breaths. I don't know if you can hear my breath. Two. One more deep breath here. Now look down, bring the right hand to the inside of the right foot, bend the right knee until the knee's above the ankle, step that left leg back, and we're transitioning right into a side angle pose. Open up the chest and press into the outer edge of that left foot. 60 degrees is how your left foot turns in. Open the chest. Feel free to tuck under and bind, or any variation if you want to bring elbow to knee. But don't collapse here. Pull in and open. Three breaths. Good. If you're just joining, feel free to do a sun salutation or two. Warm yourself up and then join in. One more deep breath. You can always watch the full thing on YouTube later. Inhale, come all the way up. Good. Exhale, both hands to the floor. Step the right leg back. Vinyasa. Chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. So lift the left leg up into the air. Bend the left knee, open up the hip. Keep the shoulders parallel. Breathe here, two. One. And then make circles with your knee in one direction. So bring it down and out. And then bring it in the other direction, warming up that hip, keeping your arms strong. And then gently step that left foot forward between the hands, right heel stays lifted, spiral the thighs in, anchor down the base of the left big toe to come up. I'm switching sides again. This is so fun. Three deep breaths. Pull that right hip forward, tuck the tailbone under, push the right heel back, push the left knee forward. Two, hold. Breathe through the nose, one more deep breath. Get deep into it as much as your body can handle. Imagine there's a lever right here and the bubble's right on the center. Pivot that right heel down, come into your warrior two. So if you need to straighten it, then come into it, go for it, sink into the hip. Open the chest to the side, so don't let this hip collapse forward. Pull it under, tuck it under, and elongate. Push the floor away from you. Push the world away from you. Don't let it affect you. Anchor yourself within. Pull yourself into the midline. Activate those arms. Let me see those warriors at home. Three deep breaths. Get deep into it. Anchor that outer edge of that right foot. Power in both feet. Plant it. Two, and one. Straighten out that left leg. Toe heel the right foot in. Pivot the hip back, bring the left hand down, right hand up, and come into your triangle pose. Open up the chest and breathe through the nose. And just enjoying this pose, enjoying this breath, being here now with yourself, with your community online. Good. If you have family around, just being aware of them, not letting them affect you.
3, 2, know that we're all in this together for the long haul. And 1, bend the left leg, left hand on the inside of the left foot, step that right leg back a little bit, and then reach that right arm up and over the head, coming into your side angle pose. You can stay right here, you can try to bind, you can bring the elbow to the knee, but notice my adjustment. We always want to open up. So even if I'm here, I'm not collapsing in, I'm opening. Imagine there's a wall behind you and both butt cheeks are touching the wall. 3 deep breaths. And smile. 2 deep breaths. Engage that back leg. Stay with me at home. 1 more breath. And then press into that left leg. Come all the way up for warrior 2. Inhale. And exhale, vinyasa, both hands to the floor. Step that left leg back. Lower down. Inhale, up dog. Shoulders pull back as much as you can. Exhale, down dog. Beautiful. Anytime you need child's pose, go into it. Push the floor away from you. Shoulders pull back. Take 3 deep breaths. 2 deep breaths. 1 more deep breath. Good. And then gently lift the right leg up into the air again. Keep the right leg straight this time. Flex the right foot. 3 deep breaths. Push the floor away. 2. And then 1. Bring the right knee into the chest and bring the right foot all the way forward between the hands. And we're going to come back up into that lunging warrior. Spiral the thighs in, shoulders pull back and hold. Good. We're going to transition into our twisted lunge here. Right arm back, left arm forward. Square those hips, extending best you can. If it hurts your shoulders in any way, bring the hand to the waist and pull the belly in and try to look back. 2 deep breaths. 1 more deep breath. Good. Now from here, left elbow is going to come to the outside of the right knee. Option A is to bring the left knee down. Option B is to keep it up. And then you can try to split the arms and reach the arm up over the head. You can also try to bring that left heel to the floor. And let's hold for 3 happy breaths. Breathe with me. 2 deep breaths. Welcome. Stay with it. 1 more deep breath. Now with control, press to the base of the big toe. Come back into your lunging warrior. Straighten out the right leg. Walk the left foot closer and square your hips. And we're going to come into twisted triangle. So left hand down, right hand up. Look up at that right thumb as you pull that right hip back. And engage the quad. Spiral the thighs in. Hold. 3 deep breaths. Breathing through the nose. Good. 2 deep breaths. Ooh. 1 more deep breath. And then lower the right hand down, forward bend over that right leg for extended forward bend. Lifting up the right toesies and the left toesies to make sure that you're not collapsing, but you're extending. So same thing here with the hips. You want to pull the hip back and hinge at the hips. 1 more breath. Beautiful. Shift the weight into the right leg, left leg up. We're going to bend this left leg and catch the left foot with the right hand, if your body allows. If not, don't worry about it. You can always use a block too to put your hands on the block. Lift up that left knee, breathe through the nose for 4. 3, pull that navel in. Engage that right quad. 2, power in your pose. Remember, your choice based on your mind or intellect. Your actions are all based on that. Step that left leg back. Right leg back. Vinyasa. Yay. Exhale, down dog. Very nice. Inhale, left leg up into the air. Flex the left foot. Square the hip. Pull the belly in. Keep squeezing for 3. 2. It's very hard for me not to just want to hit that boop, boop. 1 more deep breath. Like pressing buttons, and bring the left knee into the chest and step the left foot all the way forward. Push the right heel back, spiral the thighs in, press into the base of the big toe, and come up into that lunging warrior.
Pull the navel in, shoulders back and down. Pause. Stabilize. One more deep breath here. And we're going to twist right arm forward, left arm back. Pull in from the navel as you push the heel back. I'll do it this way so I can see you guys. Hold here for three. Pull that shoulder blade back as best you can. Two. Good. Looking towards that left hand if possible. One more deep breath. And then you're going to bring the right shoulder, elbow to the outside of the knee. If you need to bring the back knee down, go ahead. Hands in prayer. Or split the arms. Holding here. You can reach that left arm up and over the ear. Accent that back leg for three happy breaths. The happiest breaths you got, guys, because it's what you got right now. Let's do it. Two. Gratitude with every breath for what you have. Look around you and just notice all that you have. One more deep breath. Instead of what you don't or you could have. Ooh. And then inhale, come back up. We don't want that. And you're going to straighten out the left leg. Walk the right foot closer. Hands on the hips and forward bend. Right hand down, left hand up. Lift that left side of the rib cage. Breathe through the nose. Inhale deeply. Exhale deeply. Inhale deeply. Exhale deeply. Inhale. Lifting. Exhale. And then lower that left hand down. Extend it forward. Bend. Keep the hips square. So notice if you tend to collapse into one leg. Pull the hips in and lengthen. Anchor the outer edge of the right foot. Pull the navel in and kneecaps up for three full breaths. Two deep breaths. One more deep breath. Good. Walk your hands in front. Lift the right leg up. You can stay in a standing split or bend the right leg and catch the right foot with the right hand. Feel free to use blocks, whatever feels right for you. Lengthen the neck for three deep breaths. Ujjayi breath in. Ujjayi breath out. Two deep breaths. And one. Gently release. Step that right leg back into a lunging warrior. Eyes up. And exhale. Both hands to the floor. Step that left leg back and go through your vinyasa. Lower down to chaturanga. Inhale up dog. Exhale down dog. I was wondering if it looked like I was naked. I'm not naked, guys. I have pants on. Look, they have like little holes here. Sorry. I'd be like, pew! Just kidding. All right, from downward facing dog. Look between the hands and bend the knees. Step or hop forward between the hands. Look up. Exhale, forward bend, drop your head. And inhale, bend your knees. Chair pose, Utkatasana. Shoulders back, belly and tailbone under, shoulders back. You can always bring the hands in prayer if you need to. Hold here in your chair pose. Five, feel those thighs burning. Four, hold. Two, get into it, hold, tuck that tailbone under. One, hold it, bring the right knee into the chest. Cross the right leg over the left once or twice. Whoop, I'm falling. From here, then arms out to a T. And then you can bring the right arm under, left arm over. And lift the fingertips up, butt down. Hold in your eagle pose. Five, feel that in your inner thighs. Squeeze. Four, come on. We have to fly together. Three, two, ujjayi breath. One more deep breath here. Hold. And then unwind the right leg, hands in prayer in front of your heart, and pause. I was going to go more, but I figured why not? Let's pause here for a second. And back into your chair pose. Inhale, Utkatasana. Get deep into it. Bring the left knee into the chest. Cross the left leg over the right. Sink. If you can double it up, double it up. Arms out to a T. And then bring the left arm under, right arm over. Pull the fingertips up, elbows forward. So from the side, you're trying to pull forward and up. Shoulders back, belly in. Hold for four. Breathe for three. Good. Hold for two. Squeeze those thighs in towards each other. Come on, come on, come on. I'm right there with you. And one. Unwind and bring the left leg down. Samasthitihi. Good job.
Shift the weight into the left leg. Bring the right knee up in front of you. Grab the right knee with the right hand. Open up the knee to the right. Grab the right ankle and bring it in towards the left thigh. Or you can come into half lotus. So don't collapse here into that left leg. Push down into that left leg to lift and lengthen. Hands in prayer in front of your heart. You can also bring your arms up over the head. Make this left quad engage. So kneecap lifts. Good. And try not to grip with your toes. In fact, press down with the base of the index finger and lift up the left toes. If you want to challenge yourself, you can tilt your head up. You can also try to challenge yourself by closing your eyes, which you may fall. And guess what? You'll just pick yourself back up. Deep breaths. Hold for three. For two. One more deep breath. Now bring the hands back in prayer in front of your heart. Bring the right knee in front. Flex the foot. Press out through the heel. Five. Make it burn. Four. Hold. Three. We're going to hold the stretch as I promised. Two. A little higher. And one. Right leg down. I just get so excited that I have like more than an hour to teach you guys. Like, yay. All right. Other side. Press and lift the left knee up. Right hand on the waist. Open up the knee to the left. Grab the ankle, bring it in towards that right thigh, push into the leg, hands in prayer, pull the belly and shoulders down. Good. And then you can bring your arms up over the head, and you can modify how you need to, looking up, closing your eyes, push the floor away from you, ujjayi breath in, ujjayi breath out. Ujjayi breath in, let me hear you at home. Ujjayi breath out, you're doing great. Ujjayi breath in, ujjayi breath out. That's simple. That's all we're doing. We're in a tree pose breathing. That's it. And then inhale, bring the left knee to the center. Flex the foot. Push out through the heel. You don't have to touch your heel. I'm just showing you what to do. Hold for five. Squeeze and lift. Four. Breathe. Push the floor away from you. Shoulder blades are together behind you. Three. Hold. Two. Hold. Yes. Feel that burn. And one. Exhale. Lower that left leg down. Good. Arms by your side. Close your eyes and breathe. Check in with your intention, your dedication, why you are here for yourself, for others. Good. Separate your feet hip width apart. Turn your toes out. Bend your knees and come into a low squat. Elbows to the insides of the knees. Pull the belly in. Cup your hands in front. Inhale here. Exhale forward. Bend. Turn your toes in. Inhale, toes out, squat. Exhale, toes in, forward bend. We're going to do a few more rounds of this. Drop the hips, look up. Exhale, forward bend. Inhale, toes out, squat. Exhale, toes in, forward bend. Inhale, toes out, squat. Exhale, toes in, forward bend. Grab your toes in yogi toe lock. Inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, forward bend, shoulders away from the ears, elbows out. Spiral the thighs in towards each other and breathe deeply. If you don't know yogi toe lock, index finger, middle finger, come between the big toe and the second toe, wrapping the thumb around. Close your eyes. Recall your intention. Breathe through the nose and hold. Two more breaths. One more deep breath. And gently inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, turn your toes out. Bend your knees back into a squat. Now, option A, you can just stay right here. It's perfect. Stay in that squat, but don't just like hang out here collapsing. Push your elbows into the knees. Push the feet into the floor. Drop the hips, lift the chest. Or you could come into your crow pose, hands in front, squeeze at the knees, press the floor away from you, and hold for five. Breathe through the nose. Four, crow or squat. Three, or any variation you're doing at home, you can go to tripod, you can do the hokey pokey, you can turn your circle around. Two, but be safe. One more deep breath. And then hands to the floor. If you're already in crow, shoot the legs back. Vinyasa. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. All right, so we're going to bring
Actually, let's come into plank position, top of the push-up. We're going to do a little different stuff here. Lower down slowly onto your belly. Now you're going to bring your right arm out to the side. Left hand stays under the left shoulder. And you're going to roll onto your right shoulder, pushing back and letting the left leg draw back. Left arm comes up and back behind you, or you can keep it on the floor. If you need more of a stretch, bend your knees and bring your feet flat. Otherwise, stay right here. Your arm is to the side. Hold for 3 breaths. Feel that stretch in the shoulder. Good. 2 deep breaths. 1 more deep breath. Relax into that shoulder stretch. And then gently roll back onto your belly. Bring your right hand under the right shoulder. Good. And other side. Left arm out to the side. Parallel to the front of the mat. Right hand under the right shoulder. Roll onto your left shoulder. Relax the head. The right arm can come up and back behind you. And you can also try to bend your knees to make it more intense. Don't turn your bottom palm up. And relax the head. And breathe. Feel like I look like a weird bug. Hold, relax your body here. Close your eyes. 3 deep breaths. 2 deep breaths. And 1. Right hand under the right shoulder. Extend the legs out and roll onto your belly. Bring your arms by your side, toes touch, heels fall out, and kind of just shake your hips from side to side. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Close your eyes. Good, now we're gonna bend our knees and we're gonna grab our ankles. You're gonna see if you can flex your feet. If you can't reach your ankles, no big deal. Press the feet into the hands and lift up for 5 deep breaths, pointing those toes or flexing them, whatever feels right for you. Keep the legs close. 2 more breaths. Now listen carefully. You're gonna roll onto your right side, right shoulder on the floor, head on the floor, and keeping the positioning. Hold for 2. I know it's weird, Parshvadhanasana. 1 more deep breath, but we just warmed up with it. Come to the center, lift, and over to the left side. Keep the positioning, kicking the foot into the hand. Hold for 3. Hold for 2. Hold for 1. Back to the center, inhale up, and then exhale, come down. Toes touch, heels fall out. Make your hips go side to side. Turn your head in the other direction. Close your eyes. Good, hands under the shoulders. Inhale, come into your up dog. And exhale into downward facing dog. Beautiful, step the right foot to the outside of the right hand. We're gonna come into our wonderful lizard pose here. Sink the hips, point the left toes back. Walk your hands forward. You can bring your elbows towards the floor if your body permits. Keep the knee into the shoulder and breathe through the nose. 4 deep breaths. 3 deep breaths. 2. And 1. Slowly walk your hands up. Lift the chest, drop the hips. And then straighten out the right leg, coming into your forward bend. You can always slide your heel into your split if you prefer, or you could stay in a nice waterfall knee under the hip. 3 breaths, 2 breaths, and 1. Gently bend into that right knee and step it back into down dog or vinyasa. Left foot to the outside of the left hand. You can bring your arms forward, elbows down. Hold here with the knee up or down, yogi's choice. Push the floor away from you. And breathe through the nose. Four deep breaths. 3 deep breaths. 2. And 1. Slowly inhale, lifting up the chest, drop the hips. Good, and then straighten out the left leg. You can keep it in front in a waterfall. Your knee is below the hip, or you can slide the foot into your splits, Hanumanasana. And breathe here deeply. Soften into it. Close your eyes. Hinge at the hips. Belly in. Four breaths. Three breaths. Two. And one. Gently bending into that left leg. And step that left leg back. Vinyasa or down dog. From your down dog, let's come to a seated position between the hands. So extend your legs out in front of you. Pull the bottom flesh out, sit bones grounded, flex the feet, reach the arms up over the head. And exhale forward, bend Paschimottanasana. You can grab your toes, you can use a strap, but don't round the back. Lift the chest, move the sit bones back. So if you could see arrows are pointing back and arrows are pointing forward. So they're creating that traction. And then there's an arrow going whoop, and then forward bend. Three arrows at the same time. Those are the actions. But remember what we talked about at the beginning. Why are you doing these? What's the intention behind it? Is it coming from your mind or your intellect? Two more breaths. Because you could be practicing yoga because you're addicted to it. That's from the mind. Versus practicing yoga because you know you gotta do it. Intellect. Inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, release. Good. And then gently we're going, actually let's separate our feet hip width apart. Bring your hands by your hips. Now you're going to press the palms, lift the butt back. So imagine that arrow pointing back, and then you're going to scoop those hips up. So the arrow's going to go up, and then you're going to go back and forth. And we're going to try that five times, but start here, hands flat, lift the butt, scoop it up. Try not to let the butt drag on the floor. Push back, inhale up, exhale down, inhale up. Exhale down, three more. Inhale up, come on. Exhale down, inhale up. Exhale down and back. Inhale, push it up. Exhale, push it back. And then lower your butt down. Very good. From here, bring the right foot in to touch the inner left thigh. Point the right knee back. Reach the arms up over the head and exhale. Forward bend over that left leg. Pull the shoulder down and elongate, pressing that right hip down, Janu Sirsasana A. And hold here for five. For four. For three. Two. And one. Inhale, look up, flat back. Exhale, release. You're going to open that knee a little wider. Bring the left arm to the inside of the left leg. Reach the right arm up and over. Now, if you can put your hand on your foot, you're going to push your foot with your hand and your hand into your foot to create the traction. If you can't, just stay hovering and over the leg, but open it up. Five breaths. So it's not a grabbing of the foot, but it's a pushing away of the foot. Ooh, yeah. Two more breaths. One more deep breath. And then inhale, gently coming all the way up. Cross this right leg over the left, plant it flat. You can always bring the left knee in, bring the right butt cheek down, right hand behind your back. So tendency here is to round, push away and lift. As you cross and lift the chest, twisting to the right, you can always stay here or you can try to bind. Now the arrows here are arrow pointing down with your butt, and up with the right rib cage, which you may not be able to go very far, but that's okay because you're still creating that action, a little micro movement, and it's gonna start to create the opening. Look over the right shoulder, two more breaths. One more deep breath. And then back to the center. Grab that right foot, bring it back towards the left hip. So I'm gonna face forward so you can see. Coming into your Gomukhasana, cow face pose, point the toes back, lift the chest. Option A, hold the feet forward bend. Option B, your left arm's gonna go over, right arm's gonna go under, and you're gonna try to bind, and then forward bend over your legs. And breathe through the nose. Feel that stretch in the hips. And maybe it's called cow face pose because these are the lips. Hello, how are you? Two more breaths. I hope you all laughed with me. Although you might be so relaxed, you're like annoyed by my humor. It's okay. Don't let the world bother you. Push me away. One more deep breath. and slowly inhale. Come all the way up. Good. Lean back. Actually, we're going to slide into our double pigeon. Let's do that. Bring the right ankle on top of the left knee. Flex your feet a little bit. So your shins are stacked on top of each other like two logs. They're not in like this, like a crisscross applesauce, but they're stacked, right? So you don't want to bring that leg in. You want to make sure there's nothing between the thighs. And then exhale slowly, tiptoe your fingers forward into a forward bend. This is pretty intense. This is like a really hurt so good kind of pose. Breathe into it. If you need to stay upright, just stay upright. If your knee is way up high, it just takes time to get into it. Rotate that pelvis. One more deep breath. Walk your hands over to the top toe, over to the left. And then slowly hinge a little bit more if you can and press that right butt cheek down. Arrow pointing down. Pew! And then your chest pointing up. Pew! Good. Two more breaths. And one, gently coming up. Oh yeah, straighten out those legs and feel the yumminess of that right hip saying, thank you for doing this, Intellect, for choosing to do this today. Good, and then let's switch sides. Your left leg is gonna go over your right. If you have to do a vinyasa in between, be my guest. You can keep the right leg bent or straighten it, your choice, left hand behind the back. Right shoulder to the outside of the left knee. Lift up the left side of the rib cage and twist looking over the shoulder, breathing through the nose. Good, create, remember, arrow with the butt pointing down, arrow with the left rib cage going up. So create that traction. Three breaths. Pressing the right knee down, two deep breaths. One more deep breath. And then gently coming back to the center. Grab the top of that left foot and point it back towards your hip and kind of come into a nice cow face pose again. I mean, I guess it kind of looks like a cow now because my legs do look like flesh. So it looks funny. So pushing the feet down, grounding those hips, or you're gonna bring the right arm over, left arm under, and try to clasp behind your back and then forward bend. Whatever you decide to do is all good. Inhale, lengthen, so your arrows with your butt cheeks are going diagonally back and your sternum's going up. Good, holding here. Four more breaths. Three deep breaths. Two. And one, gently coming up. And slowly pull that left ankle on top of the right knee. Stack your shins on top of each other. Lift the chest, shoulders back. And then exhale. Tiptoe your fingers forward, or if you're already feeling it, stay upright. No big deal. Breathe through the nose. Flexing those feet. And lengthening the spine. Softening around the hip. And just being here now. Five deep breaths. Four deep breaths. Three. Two. And one. Walk your hands over to the right side. Press the left hip down and forward bend over that right leg. Staying with me here. Relaxing over that hip. Breathing through the nose. Soften the tongue, soften the jaw. And letting go. One more full breath here. And then gently coming up. Oh yeah, straightening out those legs. Shake it out. Extend your legs out in front of you, reach the arms in front, and slowly lower down onto your forearms. So your elbows are on the floor, your elbows are right under your shoulders. You're going to point the toes, lift the chest, and lift the heels an inch up off the floor, and hold here, activate those legs. So feel that core engaging for five deep breaths. Hold. Four. Stay with me. Come on, make those abs burn. Three. Hold. Two. Hold. One, right leg up, hold here, five, keep lifting the chest, four, come on, 3, whether you're on Twitch, Facebook, or Instagram, we're all in this together, or YouTube, one more deep breath, and then right leg down, left leg up, hold, 5, breathe, 4, hold, 3, hold, 2, hold, 1, left leg down, bring both legs up, stay on your forearms, because I gotta restart something, good, hold, for 5, hold, 4, come on guys, stay with me, 3, keep those legs straight up, 2, and 1, lie down on your back. That's it. Take a breath. Good. And then gently hugging your knees into your chest. Going on again, there we go. And we're going to come into our, hello again, you guys didn't miss much except for a boat pose if you're on Instagram, so do it. And then lift your legs up 90 degrees, option A. We're gonna do a little inverting here. If you prefer to do a headstand or a handstand or forearm stand, go ahead into it now. Otherwise, come up into your either shoulder stand, Viparita Kurani, right? Or lifting up, push the floor away from you and try to engage the back of the body as you lift up for 5, hold, keep your head still, push the floor away from you, 4, breathe through the nose, engage the whole back of your body. 3 deep breaths. You got it. 2. And 1. Lower the legs behind your head into plow. If you're lying on your back, just put the legs a little closer. Interlace the fingers if your toes reach the floor. Pull the navel in. And breathe for 4. Engage those legs. Spiral the thighs in. 3. 2 deep breaths. And 1, bend your knees to either sides of your ears, coming into Karna Pidasana. You can try to press those knees down, pull the belly in. Hopefully you can hear me. Breathe through the nose. And then gently legs together and begin to roll out vertebra by vertebra, or choose to transition into your bridge pose from your shoulder stand if you know how to do that. Bend the knees, grab your ankles, and lift your hips into your bridge pose. If you choose to do a full wheel, bring your hands under the shoulders and lift up. 5 breaths. 4 deep breaths. Come on, stay with me, guys. 3. You got this. 2. And 1. Gently coming down. Hands in prayer position on the spot between the eyebrows. Engage the core to release the lumbar. Knees together, feet apart. And then bring your arms by your side and just kind of windshield wiper your knees side to side so the feet are the width of the mat. And you're just kind of loosening up the hips here. In the back, releasing it. All right, and then bring your knees into your chest. Bring the knees to the right and look to the left. Recline, spinal twist. Keep your eyes closed. Letting yourself go here. Soften the tongue, soften the jaw. 2 more breaths. And 1, inhale to the center, knees to the left and look to the right. You can close your eyes. We're winding down. Breathing deeply, softening. 3 deep breaths. 2 deep breaths. And 1, inhale back to the center. Happy baby pose. Grab the outsides of the feet. Press the knees to the outsides of the ribs. And press those knees down at the same time. Keep your back flat, so try to point the sit bones so the arrows are going pew. The one arrow is going pew. And the knee arrows are going down pew. As you push down and hold. Press, 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 press. And release. Extend your legs out for Shavasana. Your legs are wide, your arms are wide. Adjust however you need to in order to remain completely still in your practice, in the rest of your practice, which this is the most important part for you to acclimate everything that you just did and rest and let go. So close those eyes. Relax your tongue and your mouth. Relax your lips. Relax your face. Relax your jaw. Just keep relaxing little parts of your body. Scan it for yourself and address wherever you feel that you're holding tension.
Let it go.
And let this practice be enough, and know that you are enough. You are already full. You are that true pure self, capital S. And that's why we need to study now more than ever and gain perspective on the truth, so that we can help ourselves understand what's really happening and not let our mind take over. Instead, let our intellect be sharp and keep us calm, keep us grounded, keep us in a space of love, keep us in a space of patience, of tolerance, keep us in a space of selflessness, of giving still. Even though we feel like we need to take now, we let go, we give. And the first thing you can give is your love, is your trust that you have within yourself. Money can come and go, possessions come and go, but that stays deep within your heart, that you always have. No one can take your wisdom away from you. You can stay here as long as you want in Shavasana. Otherwise, I'll start to wake you up, or just wake yourself up in this way later. Deepen your breath, making the belly rise and fall. Wiggle your fingertips and your toes. Rotate your ankles and your wrists. And roll your head from side to side. Bring your knees into your chest. Give yourself a hug. Love yourself. Go slowly, deliberately. And roll onto your right side, cup your hands under your cheek like a pillow. And with your eyes closed, slowly bring yourself up to a seated position, facing forward. Take your time. Spine long, shoulders back. And place your hands together in prayer position in front of your heart. Notice the effects of your practice today. Every day is different. We fluctuate with that mind and things change, but the intellect keeps us grounded and centered and knowing that things will change and it's going to be okay. So just observe. Two phrases to carry with you for the rest of the day. Even this shall pass away, and is that so? Anything comes, we say, is that so? If anything goes, we say, is that so? And with the understanding, the reason we say that is because we know, even this shall pass away. Let's finish by chanting Om together once. Take a deep breath in. Om. The light within me honors and loves the light within you. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining me. I am so excited to have you guys. You have a community online of people who are practicing together now and later. So thanks for being part of it. If you want to support and donate, you can go to Venmo with my full name, Rena Jakubowicz, and you can go to PayPal info@renayoga.com. Whatever you can give, and if you can't, just send some love. I'll for today, the philosophy was done before, so you can watch that part before this class. The next 2 days, it'll be a little bit different, so just check online and on Instagram and Facebook story to know what's happening for the next 2 days, only because I am traveling. But just check in, and if you need anything, I'm here for you. Follow me at Rina Yoga on Instagram so that we can stay connected. If you have questions, reach out. I'm here for you. Thank you guys for being part of it, and I will see you guys soon. Namaste.